Hey everybody, Dominic here, and I am really excited to introduce to you a new tool that we have available for CVTC faculty and students. And that tool is called Padlet. Some of you might already be familiar with what Padlet is, but if you're not, the basic idea of Padlet is that it is a virtual bulletin board. It's a way that you can have both you and your students share ideas in this kind of visual space, but you can do a lot with it beyond just doing general bulletin board type activities. And I think the best way for me to demonstrate this is just to show you some examples of what you can do with Padlet. So really quick, I'm going to run through a few examples here. So like I said, this is an example of a Padlet, and you can see that this is basically kind of like a bulletin board. You see all these different posts here with some text. In the case of this Padlet, people have also added images in. So we can see a lot of text and images that people have shared in one location. Beyond that, you could go with just images if you want to. So here's an example of a Padlet where there's really no text. It's just a collection of images, kind of a Pinterest sort of vibe going on there. Here's another Padlet that has no images. In fact, this is more like a blog where you just have these different posts. In this case, they're telling a story, but you can do kind of a blog layout with it. This example is where they're having people vote on whether something's true or false, fact or fiction. And so you can see they have the upvote, downvote options. So you could use a Padlet in that way. Another really cool example of here's a Padlet where you have different headers, and each one has the ability for people to add comments down below. So you could create different categories and then have students post to those different categories with text, images. You can even do videos or website links. There's a lot of stuff that you can post into a Padlet. Here's another example that I was putting together. This is a mind map that I created with Padlet. And so just to show you what posting in one of these looks like, I can click on the little plus symbol down here and say, put in a title. If I wanted to add some text, I could do that as well. Okay, and then I can move my post around to wherever I want. In the case of this Padlet, you can put your topics anywhere, whereas other ones, like this one back here, it actually puts them into blocks. So depending on which one you're using, you have different choices there. But then let's say that this idea connects with this idea. I can hit the little kebab, connect to a post, and then connect to that to create my mind map. Okay, so some really cool stuff you can do there. Another cool thing about Padlet is that you can embed Padlets directly into Canvas. If I go up here and click on Share, I can go to the, I could copy the link if I wanted to, or I could copy the embed code. And if I do that, I can go over to my Canvas course, and here you can see I'm inside Canvas, and here's my Padlet inside Canvas. And I can even continue posting right here in Canvas if I wanted to. You can have students post anonymously, or you can have them log in to keep track of who's posting what. To actually log in to Padlet, let me demonstrate that for you, actually. I'm going to log out of my account here. So first of all, to get to our CVTC Padlet, what you're going to go do is you're going to go to cvtc.padlet.org. And once you get there, you'll be brought to this screen right here. Click on the Login with Microsoft option, because everyone at the college has a Microsoft account. You can just connect that account directly into Padlet. So I click Login with Microsoft. If I'm logged into my CVTC, it's going to detect my email right away. You might have to type in your email address, your CVTC email address. And then once you do that, it's going to log you in to our institution's Padlet account. And from there, you can start building. I would say that if you want to start using Padlet right away, once you create your account, like I just did with the Login with Microsoft button, send an email to me letting me know, because I can change your permission from student to teacher. So just let me know if you want to start using it. One last thing I want to demonstrate for you is the fact that Padlet updates dynamically. So here's a Padlet that I made, and I'm actually going to move it to half of my screen, and then I'm going to bring in another copy of it. So over here on the left is basically, think of it as like this is the teacher view, or you know, this is one person in the Padlet, and on the right hand side here's another person on the Padlet. And if I click on the little plus symbol to start adding ideas, so I'm going to type in here, okay, you can see that as I'm typing over here on the other side, it's updating the Padlet dynamically. So you can actually do live interactions using Padlet where people are adding their ideas all at the same time. So this is an incredibly useful tool. There's actually a lot more features with it that I just don't have the time to show you in this video. I just want to give you a taste of what it can do, and the fact that logging into it and posting in it is actually a pretty simple process. So if you see any possibility of how you could utilize a tool like this in your instruction, then I highly recommend you check it out. Again, go to cvtc.padlet.org. Click the login with Microsoft button, and then once you've logged in with your CVTC email address, go ahead, send me an email, let me know so I can switch you over as a teacher. And at that point, you can start building and utilizing it in your instruction. So thanks for watching.